Hi guys, in this video today, I'm going to talk to you about action potential. So what are these action potential? Action potentials are the charge senses that cell membranes undergo, especially in neurons and muscle cells. Action potentials are important part of signaling mechanisms. For example, they are really important for communication by neurons or for the contraction of muscle cells. So what is the action? What is action potential? Action potentials are the changes of the charge across the cell membrane of nerve cells or the muscle cells. This is the definition of action potential. So this here shows the graph of the action potential, about which I'm going to explain you in details. The y-axis actually represents the membrane potential, and the x-axis represents time. Okay, so y-axis membrane potentials in millivolts, and x-axis times. And in the y-axis, you might see some numbers, minus 70 millivolts, minus 55 millivolts, 0, and plus 30 millivolts. So first, what is this part of the graph here? So this part of the graph here is called resting potential. Okay, so this is called actually resting potential. So what is this? In the resting conditions, cells are negative, slightly negative in the insides and slightly positive on the outsides. Why this voltage is negative? Because the voltage is measured from inside to outside. By using the voltage meter, we measure the voltage from inside to the outside. That's why this voltage is negative. And at the resting conditions, for the most nerve cells, the resting membrane potential is minus 70 millivolts approximately, but you know, I mean, there might be different numbers for other cells. Okay, so this part of the graph is called resting potential. So okay, when the cells are at rest, they are at minus 70 millivolt. Then how come this voltage goes up? So what is the reason for the membrane potential to go up? But when some kind of stimulus actually comes in, because of the stimulus, the positive charge from outside goes into the cell. Hence, the cell becomes less negative inside. Okay, positive charge from outside goes into the cell and the cell becomes less negative. Therefore, this voltage goes up. And why? The reason for this is stimulus. I'm not going to discuss, you know, what kind of stimulus. So simply because of the stimulus, this voltage goes up. Why? Because the positive charge from outside diffuses in the cell. Okay, so that's the reason why this part of the graph goes up, right? So the next part is, what is this dotted line here? This dotted line here is called threshold, and threshold for most nerve cells is minus 55 millivolts. Okay, this dotted line here is called threshold. And when actually the cell reaches the threshold, or when the voltage, sorry, when the membrane potential reaches the threshold or above, then what happens is that actually leads to the opening of voltage-gated sodium channel. So basically, when this membrane potential reaches threshold, that leads to the opening of this voltage-gated sodium channel. Then what happens? The sodium from outside comes inside the cell. Okay, sodium from outside comes inside the cell, and then inside the cell, the membrane potential becomes less negative, or it tries to become positive. And actually, this part is called depolarization. All this part of the graph is called depolarization. And why depolarization occurs? Depolarization occurs by the opening of voltage-gated sodium channel. And when this voltage-gated sodium channel opens, when the membrane potential reaches the threshold, then the voltage-gated sodium channel opens and sodium comes in, leading to this depolarization stays. Okay, so depolarization stays is because of the opening of voltage-gated sodium channel. So you might be thinking, you know, why this graph does not keep on going up and up, why it reaches the peak? The answer to that is, in the voltage-gated sodium channel, there is an inhibition gate. When this voltage goes up and reaches around plus 30 millivolt, then actually this voltage-gated sodium channel is inhibited by this inhibition gate here. You see this part, this inhibition gate actually inhibits this voltage-gated sodium channel, and hence sodium cannot come in. Okay, when this channel is inhibited, sodium cannot come in. So that actually leads to the peak. What is the reason behind the voltage to reach the peak? Because of the inhibition of voltage-gated sodium channel by the inhibition gate present in the voltage-gated sodium channel. And this voltage-gated sodium channel is present in the cell itself. Okay? So, okay, fine. So the cell has now reached the peak. Then why this voltage keeps, why this voltage membrane potential actually goes down? Why this membrane potential goes down? And what is this phase called? This phase or this stage of the graph is called repolarization. This is called repolarization, and this is caused by opening of this voltage-gated potassium channel. You might be wondering why after reaching the threshold, why did not voltage-gated potassium channel open then? Actually, when the membrane potential reaches the threshold, sodium channel opens, voltage-gated sodium channel opens immediately, but the voltage-gated potassium channel takes a little bit longer time to open. Okay? So the voltage-gated potassium channel actually takes a little bit longer time to open, and hence now the potassium from inside of the cell will go outside. Okay, potassium from inside the cell will diffuse outside, and hence the cell will become less positive inside the cell, and the membrane potential will keep on dropping. Okay, and this stage is called repolarization. This whole stage is called repolarization. And why this occurs? This occurs because of the opening of this voltage-gated potassium channel. And why this voltage-gated potassium channel takes a little bit longer time than the voltage-gated sodium channel. That's why, you know, we don't see both voltage-gated sodium and potassium channel open at the same time when they reach the threshold. So this stage is the repolarization. It occurs because of the opening of voltage-gated potassium channel. And what happens then? The potassium from inside of the cell will go outside. Okay, potassium from inside of the cell will go outside, and then the cell inside will be less positive. Okay, so you're right. So then the voltage keeps on dropping and dropping. Actually, it even drops beyond the resting potential. Okay, it even drops, and this stage is called hyperpolarization. This part is called hyperpolarization, or the relative refractory period. You might be wondering why this happens. The answer to this is that this voltage gated potassium channel, actually this channel takes a little bit longer time to close even if the voltage drops below the threshold. When the voltage, the membrane potential drops below the threshold, actually voltage gated sodium channel closes, but the voltage-gated potassium channel takes a little bit longer time to close. Okay, so it takes a little bit longer time to close, hence the potassium will keep on going out, hence leading to this hyperpolarization or the relative refractory period. Okay, and the next thing, this part of the graph is actually called absolute refractory period. Why this is called absolute refractory period? Because during this period, no any other action potential is possible. So that's why only one action potential is possible. No any other action potential is possible. That's why this is called absolute refractory period. And when the cells are in, okay, so this is the absolute refractory period. Why this is called absolute refractory period? Because in this period, no any other action potential is possible, no matter whatever kind of the stimulus is, or no matter how strong is the stimulus is. Okay, good. So now to the next slide. So I'm gonna play a quiz here with you guys. So what is this graph what does this graph represent? This graph represents the action potential. And what is this part of the graph is called? What is this part of the graph is called? This part of the graph is called resting potential, and the resting potential for most nerve cells is minus 70 millivolts. Okay, this part of the graph is called resting potential. And what is causing the graph to go up here in this part? What is the reason behind it? The reason behind it is, guess guys, the stimulus. The stimulus, actually some kind of stimulus comes, and that actually causes some positive charge to go inside the cell, okay, because of the stimulus. What is this dotted line in the graph is called? Guess guys, what is the dotted line in the graph is called? This is called threshold. And this threshold for most nerve cells is approximately minus 55 millivolts. Okay, this is minus 55 millivolts. What is this part of the graph is called? Guess. This part of the graph is called depolarization. Okay, and why this depolarization occurs? This depolarization occurs because of the opening of voltage-gated sodium channel. Okay, because of the opening of voltage-gated sodium channel. What is this part of the graph called? This part of the graph is called peak. This part of the graph is called peak. And why the cells actually, why the membrane potential reaches the peak? Actually, this is because of the, why? Because of the inhibition of voltage-gated sodium channel by the inhibition gate, okay? Because of the inhibition of voltage-gated sodium channel by the inhibition gate. What is this part of the graph called? What is this part of the graph called, this whole part? This part is called repolarization. This is called repolarization. And what causes this repolarization? What causes this repolarization? This is actually caused by the opening of voltage-gated potassium channel. It's caused by the opening of voltage-gated potassium channel. Okay, and then the potassium will go out from inside of the cell to outside, right? Okay, and the potassium channel takes a little bit longer time to open than the voltage-gated potassium channel takes a little bit longer time to open than the voltage-gated sodium channel. Okay, good. And then what is this part of the graph called? This part of the graph is called hyperpolarization or relative refractory period. And why this occurs? This occurs because voltage-gated potassium channel take a little bit longer time to close, okay, even after the membrane potential drops below the threshold, they take a little bit longer time to close. When this potential drops below the threshold, voltage-gated sodium channel, they close immediately, but voltage-gated potassium channel, they take a little bit longer time to close. That leads to hyperpolarization, okay, that leads to hyperpolarization. This is also called relative refractory period. And what is this part of the graph, this period here is called? This period here is called absolute refractory period. During this period, no any other action potential is possible, no matter how potent and whatever kind of the stimulus is provided. Okay? Okay, then the next question comes, okay, the voltage, after the hyperpolarization stage, then what causes the cell to go back to in the resting potential states? Actually, that is because of this sodium potassium channel and also the potassium leak channel. Okay, so what happens is three sodiums, they actually go out and two potassium come in by the this sodium potassium channel. But this potassium leak channel actually takes this potassium from inside of the cell to the outside environment, okay, at these the normal condition, at the resting condition, okay. Therefore, the cell again goes back to the resting potential condition. So, 3 sodium out, 2 potassium in by sodium potassium channel, and by the potassium goes out, because of the potassium leak channel, okay. So, I hope this video was helpful. Thank you.